Good afternoon all. Today's we will discuss the Hydel schemes components. The first principal components are, the first one is forebay, second intake structure, third penstock, fourth surge tank, fifth turbine, sixth powerhouse, seventh draft tube, and last tail, eighth tailrace. So these are the components of Hydel schemes. On the Hydel scheme is the essential elements of hydropower elements or power plants. The primary elements are, the first one catchment area, second is reservoir, third is dam, fourth is prime movers, fifth is draft tubes, sixth is powerhouse and equipment, safety devices, spillways, surge tanks and trash tanks. That intake house, waterways and tailrace and outlet waterway. These are the hydro elements. So basic elements of hydro power plant is, first is reservoir. The back space area, which is the reservoir area. Then the structure which constructed to here is the dam. And whatever type of dam, that is the gravity type of dam. There is the trestle. It is the part of trestle and trest track or forebay. It is a part of dam. It is the part of generator. These are the transformer. It is the powerhouse sections. This is the power lines. And this is the main section of turbines. Turbines, which is a control. It is a control gate. It is the intake. And when the intake flow of water to reaches to here and turbines, it's rotated and it get generated hydropower electricity. Now the surge tanks and penstock, these are the hydropower elements. The first one reservoir, second is dam, third is trest rack, fourth is forebay. Then fifth is surge tank, sixth is penstock, seventh is spillway, eighth is turbine, and last is powerhouse. So it is the typical section of power hydropower plant. Inside of our hydropower plant, there is a number of elements. The first one, number of reasons. The first is it's for required reservoir and also construction of dam. And one unit is of hydro power house, and the most required is to the distribute of electricity to the cities for the power lines, and the intake is generated to gate control gates, and the water is the main source of to the turbines, and here it is the outflow sections. So schematic section of typical hydro electric project. The HRC, it is the intake through on its radial gates. For the radial gates provided the dams, and it gets when the dam openings the gates, and it is provided to the provided to here for the turbine section, that is the EOT. It is the section of CR, and the powerhouse section is here. Here it is the transformers, and it is the gently inclined portion, which is called as penstock. So it is the schematic representation of hydroelectric project, and the layout of hydroelectric project is same as the knee head of water level, that is the reservoir level. It is the part of dam for the section is here, water flow to the portion of gate, and tunnel pressure is here, surge tanks the portion of here, penstock region is here, inlet valve, the richest water is inlet valve. Then it get rotate shaft hydraulic turbines, and remaining water to the draft tube to provide a tail water level, and it rotates the flow shafts. Electricity generator is here, the power control room is here, and The power control room provides the transformer to electricity, and it gets power lines to distribute the electric cable through the main cities. It requires the catchment area, the whole area behind the claim draining into the stream as a river across which the dam had been built, a suitable place which is called as catchment area. The catchment area, there is the number of tributaries, and it is the part of catchment area, and it is the barrier across the catchment area which is called as dam. Reservoir. A reservoir is employed to store water which is further utilized to generate power by running the hydroelectric turbines. In reservoir, the water collected from the catchment area is stored behind dam. Catchment area gets its water from rain and stream. The level of water surface in the reservoir is called headwater level. That is the headwater level. I will show you. Here it is the headwater level. The level of headwater level. Note, the continuous availability of water is basic necessity for the hydroelectric power plant. For the next is a dam. A dam is a barrier which confines the rays of water for storage diversion to create hydraulic head. Dam is generally made up of concrete, stone masonry, rock fill timber. Here it is the dam section, which is dam is generally made up of concrete, and here it is the spillways. The purpose of dam is to store the water and regulate the outflows for the water. The dam is helps to the store all incoming water. Dam is classified based on the following factors. The factor is, the first is function, shape, construction material and design. Based on function, dam is may be called as storage dam, diversion dam or detention dam. The based on the shape of dam may be trapezoidal section and it is arch dam. The material used constructing dam is earthen, rock pieces and stone masonry. According to the structural design, the dam is may be classified as the first one gravity, second arch and third is buttress dam. The types of dam, the first one we already told you, what is the masonry dam, what is the earthen dam. The masonry dams are three major classes. The first one gravity, second is buttress and third is arch. It's dam construction which is depends upon the topography of the area and material availability on the area. The in between that, the first one is gravity dam. Resist the pressure of water by the its weight, self weight. Construction of material used for it dam, which is solid, the masonry or concrete. And here it is the section of tailwater level, and this is the self-weighted portion of the dam here, and here it is the water level, headwater level. Types of dam, the first one masonry dam, second is earth dam. The masonry dam are three major classes, the first gravity dam, buttress dam and arch dam. Gravity dam also, the arch dam, it resists the pressure of water partly due to the weight and partly due to the arch actions. Arch means the curvature of the section, discharge portion of the dam, which is curvature. What is curvature? Buttress dam. The buttress is supporting flat slab. When the cost of reinforced concrete is high, such type of dam is selected for the buttress conditions. It is a concrete buttress dam. Arch dam. Arch shape gives the strength, less material and narrow sides, need for stem, strong abutment. This is the abutment sections. It is must to the stronger for the providing arch dam sections. Then arch dam, it is the example of arch dam, Greek west of Sacramento, which is in California. And it is a typical multiple arch type of dam. These are multiple arches sections, and this is the buttress regions. And I am giving the example of northeast of Phoenix, Arizona. Concrete gravity dam, wet hold dam in the place, lots of concrete. A concrete is more expensive. It is a flat slab buttress dam. Lake Tohi Dam impounds the Turkey River in the northern California. It is the roadway sections, and here it is the buttress sections, and it is the provided flat slab sections. Buttress dam, the face held up by the series of supports and the flat or curved surface, it is more favorable for buttress dam. Earth embankment dam, earth dam or rock dam. Weight resists the flow of water. It is the main portion of crest. It is the portion of weight, the reservoir level, upstream face, and in between that portion of the toe hill and reservoir level, which is called as height, and it is a discharge portion which is called toe, and it is the foundation area. Intake structure, water conveyed from forebay to penstroke through intake structure. That is the cross section of intake section. Main components are trash rack and gate. Trash rack prevent entry of debris. So it is a bedrock section. It is a main water level, and stop logs is here. Trash rack is inclined, and the inclined portion which is provide pressure shaft. It is the pressure shaft section of water tank. Actual intake where settings basin is here, then channel ways is here, forebay bank is here, and penstoke region is here. So the penstoke region to provided the vacuum pipe. Powerhouse region is here containing turbine and generator to generate electricity. Waterways. Waterways are the passage through which water is conveyed to the turbines from the dam. These may include tunnels, canals, flumes, forebays and penstokes, and also surge tanks. A forebay is an enlarged passage for the drawing water from the reservoir or the river and giving it to the pipelines or canals. Spillway. Excess accumulation of water indigenous and stability of dam construction. Spillway passage which allows the excess water to flow to the storage area away from dam. Gate it is used regulate the control of the flow of water from the dam. The first one crest control, second crest gate, and third sluice gates and walls. Pressure tunnels, it is passage to the carriage water from the reservoir to the surge tanks. So stony gate, so it is the rolled steel gate. It is the rolled steel gate, and roller train is here, and hoisting cable is here. Gate section, gate part, and side roller is here. Rubber water seal is here. Spillway crest is here. It is the section of gate seat. Now say the traitor gate. Traitor gate, the portion of water level is here, gate position when closed, and Turinian part is here. It is operate to gate chain to stop a glots lock slot, and when the Turin section is upward, the gate pier is open and dam it will provide the water. So these are the rolling gate sections. The hoisting room, it is the part of cylindrical dome, and the minimum inclination part, which is inclined rock, which is underside of spillway crest. Here it is the drum gate section. It is a sill. It is a hollow drum. It is a triangular part, which is partly triangular part, which is called as hollow drum. It is a hinge and sill. It is a hinge part. And also the butterfly wall is here. It is the disc's rotor section, closed position. It is the part of valve body, and it is the gyrosphere section of prolating rod, valve body or frame. It is the needle valve. So needle valve provides two types of breeze, and it is the flow arrows. That is the metal tie rod. The timber wooden flumes are here. Pedestal concrete section is here. Timber trace tile is here, and it is the supporting portion. Timber flume, it is a part of timber flume, and concrete flume section is here. Also steel flume section is here. Surge tank, additional storage for near to turbine, usually provided in high head plants located near beginning of the penstock. As a load of turbine decrease or during the load rejection, the surge tank provides space for holding water. Surge shaft is located at the end of tunnel. It is a well type of structure of suitable height and diameter to absorb upcoming and lowering surge in case of tripping and starting of the machine in the powerhouse. The surge shaft is provided for the gates and stop flow of water to the penstock if repairs are to be carried out in the penstock or inlet valves. Surge tank, it is a small reservoir tank or tank which is the water level rises or falls due to sudden changes in pressure. Purpose of surge tank: to serve the supply tank to the turbine when the water in the pipe is accelerated during the increased load conditions, and storage tank when the water is decreasing during the reduced load conditions. Water hammer effect: the water hammer is defined changes the pressure rapidly above or below normal pressure caused by sudden change in the rate of water flow through the pipe according to the demand of prime mover or turbine. Surge tank overcomes the abnormal pressure in the conduit when the load on the turbine falls and acts as a reservoir during the increase of load on the turbine. It is the reservoir pad, it is the gradient, it is a surge tank. Surge tank provides the tower, the inclination portion is penstock, is a power station, and here it is a turbine, and remaining water part is a tail race. Penstock are the water conduit of suitable size connecting surge shaft and main inlet valve. It allows the water to the turbine through the main inlet valve. Third is, at the end of penstock, a drainage valve is provided which drain water from penstock to the draft tube. In case long penstock is high lay head, butterfly valve is provided just before the penstock. It takes off from the surge shaft in the addition to spherical valve at the end of the penstock acting at the main inlet valve. Penstock thickness. Thickness penstock depends on the water head and hoop stress allowed. The material T is equal to PD upon 2FN. Where it is, T is penstock thickness, D is the diameter of penstock. If it is a permissible stress, and P is the pressure due to the water including water hammer. Number of penstock. Hydropower plant uses the number of turbine which are to be supplied water through penstock. To use single penstock for the whole plant, to use penstock for the turbine separately, to provide multiple penstock but each penstock supplying water to at least two turbines. Factor for selecting number of penstock: first is economy, second operational safety, third is transportation facilities. Penstock protection valves are provided after the surge shaft facilitated maintenance of the penstock. 4-way, enlarged body of the water provided in front of the penstock, provided in case the run of river plants and the storage plant. main function of the store water which is rejected by plant. Powerhouse located close to dam. Penstockies take water from reservoir. Reservoir act as forebay. Water intake structure. It consists of gated structure at the dam. Barrage to control the flow of water and provided gates along with hoisting arrangement. Normally the gates remain open and allows the water to flow to the tunnel or channel. Pressure shaft. When the water conduits in the shaft and the main inlet valve are not exposed to the atmosphere and turbid and buried in the ground or concrete due to its high pressure, this called as pressure shaft. Main inlet valve. Main inlet valves works as a gate valve, isolating valve in the water conductor system. It is located before turbine and allows the water flow from penstock to turbine. MIV acts closing valve and cuts the flow of water during the emergency trip. They are flowing type butterfly valve up to 200 meter height. Spherical valve more than 200 meter height. It is a butterfly valve structure. Same as the butterfly valve, spherical valve. Turbines are used to convert the energy water of the falling water into the mechanical energy. Turbines, the rotary engine that takes energy from moving water. Flowing water is directed on the blades of the turbine runner, creating force on blades. Since runner is spinning, the force acts through the distance. In this way, energy is transferred from the outwater flow to the turbine. The principal types of turbines are, first one, impulse turbine, second is reaction turbines. It is a section of turbine generator shaft, water flow, turbines blades are here, vehicle gates are here, and stator part is here. And rotator part is inside the stator. Pelton turbine, turbine pelton is, it actually the actual type of Pelton turbine, it is EN, FR is a turbine pelton, FES is a turbine pelton. Kaplan Francis, it is a type of turbines. Draft tube is a pipe or passage gradually increasing cross sectional area which is connect the exist or tail race. It reduces high velocity of water discharged by the turbine. Draft tube permits the turbine to install a higher level than the trace level, which helps maintains the repair of turbines. Draft tube is located between the lower ring of turbine and tail race also. These are the types of draft tubes. Conical draft tubes, elbow draft tubes, moody draft tubes. Elbow draft tubes is often preferred the most of the hydropower plant. The draft tube has advantage to the conical portion at the center, reduce the wheel action of water with the high velocity center reduce. Spillways. We already discussed overflow spillway, chute or side spillway, shaft spillway, siphon spillway. These are the sections of shaft spillways, overflow spillways, chute spillways and side channel spillway. Siphon spillway. You very well known about the siphon spillway. Power generation. The amount of electricity that can be generated by hydropower plant depends on two factors, flow rate and head. Flow rate, it is a quantity of water flowing in a given time. Head, the height of which water falls, the generator of flow and head more electricity produce. Powerhouse. The powerhouse has building which turbines. Alternators having auxiliary plant are housed. Some important items of equipment provide and the powerhouse are follows. Turbine, generator, governors, relief valves, gate valves, transformers, switchboard, equipment and instrument, oil circuit breaker, storage batteries, outgoing connections, cranes, shops and offices. The shaft surface powerhouse has been broadly divided into three subdivisions which are separated by from the intake mentioned below: substructure, intermediate structure, superstructure. The tail water level, trail trace water level after the discharge of the turbine. The discharge water sent the river, thus the level of the river is tail water level. Generator. Hydro generator is coupled of the turbines and convert the mechanical energy transmitted by the turbine to the electric energy. Generator can be suspended type or umbrella type. Main generator components are stator, rotator, upper bracket, lower bracket, thrust bearing, slip ring, air coolers, brake and jacks, stator heaters. Governor. Used controlling the guide vanes by the detecting turbine speed and its guide van opening order to keep turbine speed stable or regulate its supports. Auxiliaries and attached with the hydel power plant, electric instrument generator, transformers, switch gears, other instruments, control rooms, mechanical instruments, shaft coupling, bearings, lubricating oil system, cooling system, brake system and generator turbine shaft. This is the dam level of cresting drop water. It is a turbine or force falling level. It is a reservoir of water storage. Transmission lines are here and it is the part of generator. Natural distribution of electricity produced by origin of falls. Hydropower is an important renewable energy source worldwide. These are the some examples. Advantage of hydropower: clean and safe source of energy. They are safe, self-sustaining. They create habitat more types of fishes. They can act as flood control. They are most efficient energy sources, running from 90 to 95%. Other from hydropower, tidal power, generated turbines move the tides, ocean thermal power generated from the thermal expansion of oceans. Thank you.